You put in the time. You put in the sweat. Because you never know what can happen. But here at St. Joe's, there is one thing we know for sure. The Hawk will never die.
What I did note was in August that I had a really good team. Now, whether we could be in good in basketball, two different things. But in terms of a team, a group of guys that you could get with, they liked being together, they were willing to work for a common cause, they enjoyed being part of this, they enjoyed each other.
You can point to that unique brand of chemistry when remembering the 2015-16 St. Joseph's Hawks as one of the best teams ever to set foot on Hawk Hill. SJU won its second Atlantic 10 championship in 3 years, reached the second round of the NCAA tournament, and reeled off 28 victories, the second highest total in the history of the program. Now, entering the season, there was cautious optimism surrounding this St. Joseph's team. The Hawks had won just 13 games a year ago, but brought back three seniors and a Player of the Year candidate in DeAndre Bembry. They were an experienced group, but question marks surrounded the team's ability to score. The answer to that one was known very quickly, with the emergence of Isaiah Miles as one of, if not the most improved player in the nation. Among the early season highlights, Bembry scoring his 1,000th career point against Buffalo, and sophomore Shavar Newkirk stepping into the spotlight late in the game against Old Dominion.
5 seconds. Shavar gonna go. Tries a step back. Shavar Newkirk jumper is good!
December began with a loss to 7th-ranked Villanova at Hagen Arena, but the Hawks rebounded and won 6 in a row the rest of the month. Included in that stretch was a hard-fought overtime win at Temple, where SJU received double-doubles from Bembry and Miles. But it was freshman Lamar Kimball showed he wasn't bashful about taking the big shot, connecting on an eventual game-winning three-pointer with just over 2 minutes left in overtime for SJU's first win on North Broad since 2008. St. Joseph's made an early appearance at the Barclays Center, taking on Virginia Tech at the ACC A-10 doubleheader. The Hawks scored an impressive win, but maybe more importantly, the game served as a coming-out party for Miles. The senior poured in a career-high 36 points, 25 of them coming in the second half. He added personal bests of 15 rebounds and 4 blocks as the Hawks won going away. And begin another lengthy winning streak by defeating Rhode Island at home. Bembry led the way with 22 points, but it was senior Aaron Brown who continued to show just how valuable he was, scoring 19 points, including 4-for-4 from the outside. Victories over UMass and at Rhode Island increased the Hawks' streak to 7 consecutive wins, while SJU remained unbeaten on the road. But it was another home game that prevented the Hawks from achieving their 8th win in a row, as they began February with a loss to St. Bonaventure. The Hawks would bounce back with a win at Fordham and then faced a key Atlantic 10 matchup with George Washington down in the nation's capital. As had been the case all season long, it was a balanced effort from SJU, led by 21 points and 9 rebounds from Miles, punctuating one of the Hawks' most dominating and complete performances of the year. SJU led from the start and put the game away with 64% second-half shooting. St. Joseph's remained the nation's only undefeated road team and posted the 20th win of the year, marking the 9th season of 20 or more under Phil Martelli. After a Big 5 win over LaSalle, the Hawks faced one of the nation's hottest teams. It was 15th-ranked Dayton coming into Hagen Arena for a first-place showdown. With the gym filled to capacity and reaching its highest decibel level of the season, Brown got the Hawks out to a quick start. The teams played through what was 8 lead changes and 2 ties before SJU broke it open in the second half. Bembry and Miles each posted double-doubles, and Brown, Kimball, and James Demery all contributed double figures in a 79-70 win.
Trying for the rebound, it knocks to Kimball, out ahead Demery, punctuation, a one-hand slam!
The victory gave SJU a share of first place and marked the highest-ranked opponent beaten in Hagen Arena since back in 2008. Hit the fast-forward button to Senior Day. After wins over UMass at St. Louis and a road setback at St. Bonaventure, the Hawks entered Hagen Arena determined to send their seniors out in style. Miles fittingly scored his 1,000th career point, a remarkable feat considering he had entered the season with just 444. The Hawks were off their game, and the upset by the Dukes put a damper on the festivities. After suffering back-to-back L's for the first time all year, St. Joseph's began hearing doubts about its NCAA tournament hopes. As the fourth seed in the Atlantic 10 tournament at the Barclays Center, the Hawks still earned a double bye. But the two-game losing streak increased tension surrounding the quarterfinal matchup with GW. Many pundits felt it was a win-or-go-home scenario for St. Joseph's, and after falling behind by 14 points in the first half, it appeared as if SJU would lose its third straight game and potentially have to settle for an NIT bid. Cue the Hawks' biggest comeback of the season in the second half, playing with a sense of urgency that allowed them to chip away at GW's lead. Baskets by Brown, Miles, and Kimball paced the Hawks during that stretch, while a three-pointer by Demery with over 6 minutes left completed the comeback. Add in three the old-fashioned way by Brown to put SJU in the lead for good, and the Hawks sealed the victory down the stretch to notch the 25th win of the season and the 400th of Martelli's 21-year coaching career. Top-seeded Dayton was the next obstacle in St. Joseph's path. But seniors Miles, Now, and Brown made sure that the Hawks would have more games to play. SJU held a double-digit lead early in the second half, but saw Dayton close to within 3 points. That's when Papa Now took over, scoring 11 straight points with 3 three-pointers to build up the lead. The Hawks held off Dayton in the final few minutes as Brown went a perfect 6-for-6 from the foul line to give St. Joseph's its second trip to the A-10 title game in the past 3 years. Demery and Kimball joined the seniors in double figures, while Bembry had another stellar all-around game with 9 points, 7 rebounds, and 8 assists. Selection Sunday, and the Hawks face second-seeded VCU in a rematch of the 2014 A-10 championship game. And the result was more of the same. Brown got the Hawks out to a strong start with 10 first-half points, and St. Joseph's led by 9 at the half. The Hawks expanded that lead to as many as 21 points in the second half, but VCU wouldn't fold as the Rams answered with a 14-5 run to tighten up the game. As they had done all year, Miles, Bembry, and Brown made plays down the stretch to seal the victory. Bembry scored a game-high 30 points. Miles had 26 to go with 12 rebounds.
Off the glass, and good.
And Brown added 13 as the trio was named to the all-championship team. Miles capped a stellar senior year by earning the tournament's Most Outstanding Player Award. But as it turns out, he was only getting started. The victory gave St. Joseph's the fourth A-10 title in program history, and more impressively, the second in 3 years. A select group of Hawks, DeAndre Bembry, Isaiah Miles, Papa Now, Javon Bauman, Brendan Casper, and Kyle Molock cut down the Barclays Center nets for the second time. St. Joseph's guaranteed that there was at least one more game to play by punching its own ticket to the dance with the conference's automatic bid.
For a team picked to finish 7th in the Atlantic 10 preseason poll, the Hawks surprised everyone en route to their second A-10 title in 3 years. It was especially emotional for the top two Hawks, DeAndre Bembry and Isaiah Miles.
It's an amazing feeling. Got credit out to this guy, man. He's playing the game right here. Without him, wouldn't be where we at right now. Without this man right here, man. I love this dude. It's my brother right here. I love this dude, man.
Look at the tears right now from both of you. It's unbelievable. You just caught up with emotion. Yo, just realizing it now that you won a championship, aren't you?
Man, this was my first time crying. This is so special, man. I'm happy he got to leave with his senior year like this, man. It's so special.
And how about for the way you both played in this game? You both stepped it up.
Amazing. Our team needs us. Our team needs us in this huge game, and I'm glad that we showed up for him. You know, it's not just us. We have seniors. We have freshmen. Everyone contributed. This is a team win, and I'm glad I couldn't win with no other group. I'm glad to finish my senior out with this group.
This will be Phil Martelli's seventh trip to the NCAA tournament in 21 seasons on Hawk Hill. But there's something special about this group.
It's been a special group since August. The result would not have taken away from the fact that they were special. They're older. They were wired in last night. They gave me the sense that if we didn't win, it would be because we got beat, not because we lost the game.
What made this win for St. Joe's so special is that they played as one unit. As assistant coach Jeff Arnold told me, we're like Noah's Ark. We have two of everything.
With a 27-7 record, St. Joseph's was optimistic about its potential seeding for the NCAA tournament and received its highest since the perfect season. The 8-seeded Hawks were sent to the West Region in Spokane, Washington, making one of the furthest trips of any school in the tournament. The team wasn't fazed by the distance and relished the experience, but still had work to do on the court in the matchup with Cincinnati. The game turned out to be one of the tournament's instant classics that came down to the wire.
Aaron Brown, splash! To open up the biggest lead of the night.
St. Joseph's held a slim halftime lead and forged ahead in the second half with a 15-2 run. But Cincinnati answered back with a run of its own to tie the game with 6 minutes to play. The teams traded leads and the Bearcats held a 76-75 edge with just 16 seconds to play.
Down to this. Miles, that's a three. Boom! Got it! He got it! 2-point game. Copain inside. Ellis, does it count?
The question on everybody's mind during that official review, did that dunk in fact count?
No basket! No basket! And for the first time, six guys named Nelson, West, and Carroll roam campus. The St. Joseph Hawks have won an NCAA tournament game.
For Miles, the first game-winning shot of his career. And the Hawks, the two-point victory. Their first in NCAA tournament play since all the way back in 2004. Top-seeded Oregon was next, and the Hawks were up for the challenge. Early foul trouble hurt St. Joseph's, falling behind by as many as 10 points. But SJU wouldn't fold and outscored the Ducks 23-6 to take a 58-51 lead with just over 5 minutes to play. Oregon countered with a run of its own and was able to escape with a 69-64 win to end for St. Joseph's what was a remarkable season. The loss, of course, was disappointing, but didn't diminish what the Hawks accomplished in that 28-8 season. DeAndre Bembry earned a host of awards and was cited for his leadership and all-around play by being named the Player of the Year in the Atlantic 10 and the Big 5. Isaiah Miles had the best season of his career and was recognized for his transformation into one of the conference's top players, earning the most improved awards from both the A-10 and the Big 5 as well. Phil Martelli was honored for one of the best seasons of his career as the Big 5's Coach of the Year. A strong supporting cast with Brown, Now, Demery, Newkirk, and Kimball all making key contributions, as did every man on the Hawks roster. At the start of the year, the Hawks were projected to be a good team, but St. Joseph's turned out to be a great one, full of memories to last a lifetime for the program, the university, and one another. And in the words of their head coach, carrying with them a permanent tattoo, the 2015-16 version of the Crimson and Gray. Always champions, forever Hawks.